use this guideline, we should not modify it, we should not change it, but you can use it, download it, but not to copy anything from it. And even I can't insert any slide in it. So that's a safe presentation.
It starts with that word is changing. So there's a Moody law, heard about it? So it's a semiconductor law which talks about that every 18 months, the 1 square centimeter of IC will have double the transistor. Like the ICs are becoming more and more complicated and more powerful, and the growth is exponential. And this has been observed for more than like half a century. So in the same way,
contradictions have been presented.
Yeah, but the idea is that things are moving fast. So that is the intention. And in the same way, the software is also changing. The software world is also moving fast, and world is becoming complex day by day. So that is, and that's why we need to focus on the power of agile and lean to ensure that we remain in line with the need of changes and bring this agility at an enterprise level. So this is something, fun thing that we think when we are a software developer, we are doing something great, like working like this. But a lot of people think like this, that we are sitting here and working like, okay, we have a software factory, which looks like this. Okay, now the funda which starts here is that, they start with the Devin core, that it is not enough to management just commit to a quality and productivity, they must do something to bring the change. So in the lean agile philosophy, especially in lean philosophy, they recommend that management should commit to change the system. Because if they cannot change the system, who else can? It's just not like, okay, we believe in quality, we believe in productivity and other things. They should focus on changing the system. So be agile is the first thing which they start about. It compares waterfall versus agile. So in our group, I think we don't need to talk about it. It is something which we all understand, how the values are getting converted. Again, this graphics also talks about that in waterfall, we deliver value at the end because big batch size, with a small batch size, we deliver value faster. So in our group, I think we don't need to discuss this. And same way, so the same graphics is presented in a three way that, okay, we get few fast value, less time, etc., etc. So this is more or less agile versus waterfall, which I think we all are aware of. Now scaling up. So we need to start how to scale. And this is something the Scaled Agile framework is all about. Now it has values. It focuses on 4 core values of sales, SAFE, which is program execution, alignment, code quality, and transparency. So when we see alignment, now when you were talking about scaling the agile principles, we were figuring out that there are many things which get dependencies, alignment issues, how do we integrate our code, how do we integrate our priorities, etc., etc. So there were alignment issues. Here, in SAFE, it is recommended that we should have a good alignment from portfolio, program, and team level. And in order to have this alignment better, we should also have a transparencies. There should be a good transparency. What is happening at a team level should be visible till portfolio level. Our traditional management problem that people at portfolio level are not much aware what really working and what is not getting executed. So this is the another value which focuses on transparency. Program execution is that not only the team's working, but as a program, we should have a focused approach on executing program. So this layer focuses on the complete program execution and code quality. So it does believe in that you need to have engineering practices which can scale. You need to have a strong engineering practices which can make this all things happen. So code quality at a team level remains the focused area in SAFE. So these are the 4 core values of SAFE. Here is some history which talks about like, we had a version 1.1 which came in 2012, 2013, and now we have a version 3 of SAFE. This version keeps changing. They do very frequent update at this particular website. So you can go to a scaled agile framework. These all items are clickable items. So for example, if you want to know what is this business epic, you click it, you get a complete note on it. Very descriptive note with images, with interlinkings. And freely available. So wherever you want to read, you can do it, and the updation keeps happening. And even people like us, this is the only repository. So So before this training, I spent good time reading it here. So he's the one who created it or who compiled it. He has written multiple books like Agile Software Requirement, Scaling Software Agility, and many. He worked as a coach as well as an executive, and you might have heard many of his videos or webinars, and he keep visiting in some of our conferences also. And I think the Agile Bangalore, again, is focusing on scaling, which is happening on March, I guess. So they have a theme of scaling, and many safe evangelists have put their proposals. So you can see what they are trying to speak on. Again, the group, the methodologies, the contributors, and so as I said, I cannot modify the presentation, so we have to go with it. Else I would have deleted good amount of content from it. So now, yeah. So you are interested in this picture?
No, I'm just interested in the people.
I find most boring thing. Okay. So now the another good thing is how they manage this. So they focus on this SAFe is focusing on like enterprise level adoption. So SPCs are expected to be consulting organizations to become scale. So to implement SAFe Agile framework, and they have a community of certified professionals. So we spoke about like SPC, we spoke about Space Agilist, we spoke, there are SAFe professional, there are SAFe product management, PM, the product manager level, there is a certificate for that also. So this is the business model where they create community, this is a free content. Again, you cannot copy it, you cannot reproduce it, this particular content. Now what about Agile? Now SAFe believes in Agile. Now a lot of time when even I was exploring about SAFe, I was going through various blogs, somebody was saying SAFe, it is not Agile. It is traditional project management. It is PMP version of Agile. It is Prince 2. So there were like, you find so many comments here and there. Say SAFe is nothing but it's a Prince 2. So you find many. But in reality, if you get into the content, you will find at a team level, it focuses on pure Agile values. So it is adapting complete Scrum project management framework, including ceremonies, roles, and artifact at a team level. It is adapting engineering practice of extreme programming at team level. You see continuous integration, test first, these engineering practices are explicitly mentioned here. It follows Kanban principles for limiting work in progress, managing demand, extensively at portfolio level, and also making cadence based work. Cadence is like time box, fixed duration period. So that approach is also taken from Kanban, which we limits work in progress, manages the flow. So it is imbibing lean and agile principle. Lean gives a way for scaling, actually. Because in Agile, we believe too much on inspect and adapt, whereas Lean believes that it is good to do a continuous improvement, but you need to have some model to start with. You refine that model, but you should have something which gives a predictability. So it is mixing of taking both the values and moving forward. So how do we scale? So these are like, okay, beyond boundaries and trees. So we had a good discussion on this. So this is something we will take. So focusing on time to market, quality product engagement, case studies. So you can go to scaledagileframework.com/case studies. A lot of case studies are available where they are sharing how SAFe helped them in scaling. And the Info Game One is the one which usually seen in India because it's Indian company again, and they are focusing on outsourcing. So SAFe in outsourcing environment, that is something which anyway. And what they have done is they have another section which is talking about guidance. So they have a guidance for implementing SAFe in a very regulated environment. Guidance means they are providing some extended guideline for medical device and regulated industries, because there the change becomes a bit difficult. So this is a value thing which you can use and explore. And this presentation itself you can download from scaledagileframework.com. Go into presentation. Now there is a house of Lean, and when you read about SAFe, even in this big picture also, this is given here. So this is kind of a principle, like values which this the complete SAFe framework talks about. They talk about that we are the three pillars of this house of Lean are respect for people, we know, respect people, agile, scrum, lean, everywhere it is there. Product development flow is something new for this community, and Kaizen, continuous improvement. And they focus on that we should have a leadership who believes in lean and agile values, and we should focus on giving value to the end customer by delivering continuous values. So we will get something in detail. Focusing on goal. So a lot of time when we, but it is not specific to SAFe only, it's general lean and agile philosophy. Many times when I train in corporates, especially in corporates, people talk about that we will be less efficient when we work in an agile environment. Because I'm a tester, I can do a good testing if I only do a testing work. And initially, the manufacturing organizations were also developed focusing on productivity. How efficiently you can do this work. As we started moving towards lean, as we started moving towards critical chain methods, we started moving towards profitability. That even if you are less productive, but ship things, deliver the inventory into cash, and reduce that service time. Even if you spend more time than your ideal time, but if your service time is less, focus on it. So similarly, here we talk about that we need to focus on speed, quality, and value. So focus on delivering things with a sustainable, shortest lead time. And this one is very interesting, which is coming as a lean, that we need to figure out a way to deliver software so fast that customer don't have time to change their mind. And if you get into the details, whenever you can retrospect, if you have delayed project, it will get more delayed because people will put more requests to it. Because they trust less on you now. They want to push it that when the work is done, and a lot of time the delayed projects becomes feature magnet. So the things which remain fast, they remain fast. If something is delayed, everything comes to it. So this one is a very interesting thing. Philosophy, this quote focuses on delivering things from concept to cash. So how fast we can convert, like we have a concept, we may want to launch 3 products, I keep thinking about new ideas. How fast it can get converted into cash, that is important. Just making content and talking about SAFe is not important. How fast I can sell the training is important. So that is a process of concept to cash. I am also struggling here. Anyway, and this is also an interesting one. The most software problem will exhibit themselves as a delay. So a lot of them say this is delay. This lean concept talk about if there is a delay, it means there is some problem. Other problem. Delay is an indicator of other problem. It looks like delay is a problem, but delay is not the problem. Delay is an indicator of problem. So good thing to read. And then respect for people. Yeah, don't trouble them. Don't overload them. Don't make them wait. Don't impose wishful thinking. Don't force people to waste their time. You know? I was reading the new book of Jeff Sutherland. He was talking about that the new book, doing twice the thing in half the time. He's just written Scrum doing double the thing in half the time or something. It has a different name in our country. So what he's talking about? Waste. He's saying that if you are involved in wasteful activity, because time is finite, it is kind of silent suicide because you are wasting your time. Time is finite. So don't force people to do a gradual suicide by wasting their time. Interesting thing. So I tweeted the exact quote, but it was good. So yeah, so respect people. Kaizen, continuous improvement. Now, a lot of case studies can be seen that the perfect team does not remain perfect, they don't inspect and adapt. One time I was doing a training, then somebody says, doesn't it look like too stressful for the team? If the team is doing good, why they have to improve? They will feel demotivated that we still have to improve, still we are working good. So it is nothing to demotivate you, it is to make your work better. And in a Scrum concept, the continuous improvement leads to happiness. That's why we talk about retrospective. The goal of retrospective is making your work more productive, more happy. How to make subsequent iterations, sprint, more productive, joyful, and happy, bring happiness to you. So focus there that we want to improve because we want to improve our life, as well as product, as well as organization. Now this is something new. Okay, I am giving a brief idea about it. It's an interesting book. Most of our Agile fellows might not have seen this particular book. He has written a previous book named The Design Factory. Fortunately, I worked with that book for a while before even I was working in a company named Secure Meters, and we were implementing the Design Factory. And this book is all about implementing lean principles in new product development environment, in creating new products. So it differs in many areas from the core lean principles, like it criticizes the 80-20 principles in some extent. So it says that don't get too much associated with 80-20. There are a lot of things which remain beyond 20 and they still add value. So it has a different view, and SAFe implements most of their principles. In SAFe Agilist training, we spend approximately 2-3 hours in just understanding these concepts. So brief idea, it focuses on taking an economical view. So it says that your decision making should be based on economics. You may avoid economics, but economics will not leave you. So what does this economics mean? It is focusing on how much money we can generate out of a given work. They have a way that if you can't quantify anything else, quantify cost of delay. So the product development flow focuses on cost of delay a lot. Traditionally, we focus on values, risk, cost, so general things. So they talk about cost of delay as a factor. That if cost of delay is high, you need to do things faster. You need to prioritize that particular thing faster. So it talks about take an economic way. It has a problem with the queue, that you need to manage your queues. It talks about a lot of traffic related examples. How do we manage queues and how queue handling can be a result. It talks about that if there is a queue, it becomes less productive for even the developer, because he gets stressed when he sees a lot of people waiting for it. If things remain in flow, after one thing he gets a short break, another thing comes, it goes fast. And usually when you have a high utilization, there will be a queue. What does it mean, high utilization? For example, you have a long queue in front of an airline counter. And you have a limited counter, but they are good enough. So initially there were 2-3 people only queue, and people were working efficiently. But if something goes wrong, one customer requires 2-3 things. Since the utilization was high, you will end up into long queue. And as the queue will become long, people will get irritated and the processing will start going down. So it focuses on those areas. It focuses on exploiting variability. A lot of time we focus on that, that the manufacturing talks about that we should have a predictable things and less variable things. It says that in new product development, you cannot have 100% control on variability. You should use them. Variability means sometimes you are making B, sometimes you are making something different, and you don't produce all the time the same thing. So reduce batch size, so it is more or less same like our lean Kanban principles. Apply WIP constant. So what is work in progress constant? That we will not do more than X amount of thing in a given point of time. So I'm talking because many of you are already aware of these things. Control flow under uncertainty cadence. So it focuses on cadence. Now what is cadence? Same like release train. So release train has to work in a fixed cadence. 2 weeks sprint has to be 2 weeks sprint. And if you decided that your release or a product increment would be a 5 sprint, it should be a 5 sprint. Now it brings some level of synchronization. Like you know that if you miss this thing, the next time it will be happening at this particular point. If you start giving them a flexibility, then the problem will start. As I said, the delayed things bring more features and things will start getting delayed. So it focuses on that you should control flow with synchronized cadence. Feedback, so short feedback. And another thing is the decentralized control. So this book also focuses on that there should be a different level of decision making happening here and here, and the decisions which has to be taken here should be decentralized. It should not happen that for small things, and the decisions which has to be taken frequently should be decentralized. The decisions which does not have a big financial impact or a strategic impact should be decentralized. So there should be a clear demarcation what should be decided here and what should be decided there. So it's an interesting book. It cost 2,600 rupees. There is no Indian version to it, but it's a good one. If you think of getting into safe implementation or further, understanding the product development flow principles are good. If you attend my essay training, you will anyway get away with it. Okay. So nothing beats the agile team again. So now this presentation is starting on the framework, the scaled agile framework, and it again re-emphasizes that agile team remains the base of it. So at a team level, we are focusing on delivering value, fully tested software every 2 weeks. We focus on empowered, self-organizing, self-managed teams. Team operates under the program vision, architecture, and user experience guidance. From where it comes? Here. So like you have a program objective, the UX guy is giving guidance, the system architect is giving guidance. Guidance, not rule, guidance. So they work under those guidances. Scrum project management, pure Scrum ceremonies are implemented here. XP practices implemented here, and we deliver values via user stories. So here we work on user story, invest user stories. Team, so that is something we have discussed, and we focuses on all engineering practices which is coming from extreme programming, agile architecture, emerging architecture, continuous integration, test first, refactoring, pair programming. So code quality remains one of the important value of it, and there is no shortcut for engineering practices. And at a scaled environment, you need more strong engineering practices because things has to move fast, else you will not be able to achieve the synchronization in cadence. There will be always problem. Now, self-organizing system. So here we have Edward Deming talking about the system must be managed, and it will not manage itself if we left it to themselves, component themselves, because they will become selfish, competitive, independent, profit centers. Means, if you have a system, you can't leave it on, they will get self-managed. You need to have an approach of managing system. And in here, we have a two system. One system, which we are developing through release stream, software. So software also has to be managed in a way that it remain as a, my authentication is world class authentication system. Now, my software is not only about authentication, I am developing a full e-commerce platform. So I have to think about my complete e-commerce platform rather than only authentication. So that has to be managed well. The different system is this system, people, program. So if we don't manage their shared visions, they also become selfish. So we need to have a proactive approach to manage both the systems. So that is something which is the fundamental from SAFe. And for that we have program management. So the middle layer is basically ensuring that we have self-organizing, self-managing team of agile teams. So what is program management? It's a collection of agile teams plus few guys who are staying at this level. So working, they produce system increment every 2 weeks. Now working software, as I was talking about, we have to see working software in two levels. So we do have a working software which is coming here, demo and retrospective. Every 2 weeks, team produce a demo. But this demo is an independent demo, not necessary to be integrated demo. If you have a good continuous integration, you may have some extent of integrated demo. But once this demo is done, then there has to be a system demo, which is a collection of it. And this system demo also should happen every 2 weeks at a program level. And there is a separate team, system team, who has a responsibility of giving this system demo. So we have an approach. Now, can we do it in the same day? Maybe not. Maybe 2-3 days after the previous iteration of has closed. The maximum deviation SAFe allows is 2 weeks. So that before the next output come, you should have a system demo.
System demo means integrating the work done by different.
Yes, and showing it to a program level stakeholders, product management, all these guys. So they see a holistic, not pieces. So in order to ensure that system is integrated, aligned to a common mission and vision in a single backlog. So it program backlog. So we have a program backlog which is helping us to align into a single vision and a mission. Common sprint length and estimating. Now there is a controversy. Okay? Unlike agile teams, here we do believe in normalizing of story points. We can't live on each team's define their story point as per their perspective. No. So that is, sometimes it ends into a controversy, but yeah, it's a point we should be kept in mind that we have rule here, which says that we need to focus on alignment. Okay? So face-to-face release planning, which we do at the breaks, and cadence of collaboration, alignment, synchronization, assessment. So that is something we are talking about. Now here we deliver benefits with features. So we deliver features at a frequency, and that delivery happens via features. So feature is an industry term, which is usually a bigger than user stories, and we deliver things with features. Okay, that's the second layer. So how does it happen? We will have a program increment. So as I was talking about here, so we have a program increment. Program increments are happening at, say, 5 sprints or 6 sprint level, and each iteration is also producing into system depth. Now there is another fine-grained difference here. Program increment is not equals to release, not necessarily equal to release. So SAFe believes on a concept called release on demand. Develop on cadence, release on demand. What does it mean? It says that we would be running, for example, say let's take, we have taken a PI as a 10 week means 5 iteration thing. So we would be finishing program objective every 10 weeks. But it doesn't mean that only after 10 weeks we will have a release. Release means a production release of our software to a market. It could happen in between. Any time when we have a product ready, we may have release. So release could be a situation based, could be a milestone based, and not necessarily synchronizing with PI ending. Though majority of organization plans release along with the PI cadence, but it is not a mandate. It can happen in on demand. So idea is, by delinking these two things, it makes sure that cadence never get broken. You keep working throughout your life in the same 10-week cycle.
And it's not mandatory to have a release in PI.
Yes.
It's not mandatory.
So release is something, you do a release planning and you release when the planning objectives are met. But you would be working as a PIs. So you would work in a quarter cycle or a 5-week cycle, and as you achieve your release, so they talk about release on demand. Work, develop on cadence, release on demand. So stay lean. So we spoke about agile. How do we use agile? Again, now we are something here, you know. We talk about lean because we are reaching here.
Just one question.
Yeah.
The shared DevOps, UX, system architect, RDEs. But these are all shared resources. We keep on managing these. So now, when we structure a team, these teams would have the people from these. So a Scrum team may have dedicated architect.
That's a team member.
And these people, so we can count them as a COEs or these kind of people.
Yes, you can count them as a community of practice owners
or COE,
whatever. And they promote the community of practice.
So then these would be, so if there are multiple projects, maybe so there are
multiple release chains.
No, what I'm saying is there are four, we have shown four teams here.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
One, two, three, four. Mm-hmm. Right, but there could be maybe 10, 20
teams. There could be multiple teams.
Multiple teams. And they all would be...
if they are sitting into one release chain. So you have a hierarchy of trains.
So there would be multiple
trains
for multiple release chains.
Yes.
That layer.
So these two layer is one train. At a portfolio level, we are showing multiple trains. And each train will have this. Train is a separate group. So now we are at a lean Kanban level. We talk about portfolio. So system is a network of interdependent components that work together to try to accomplish an aim of the system. So we have to focus that we should have a system level aims. We should have a portfolio level aims. If you don't have it, we will not be able to align ourselves as we were talking about, that if you don't manage the system, they will become selfish. In order to manage the system, we should have a goal, which are common. Okay, so here we have portfolio level things, and it focuses on that centralized strategy, decentralized execution. So here we do a decentralized execution, but the strategy is centralized here. Lean agile budgeting, so like focus on values. Kanban system to provide portfolio visibility. So you have a Kanban system which shows that what items are lying at which particular stage of a review. You also know that WIPs, that can we implement them or cannot implement them. So those kind of visibilities is available there. Here also, yeah.
At this level, how we can do a
WIP? Kanban level. For example, you...
At Kanban level. But this is a portfolio. This is
So for example, you cannot think of more than 5 business initiatives at a time. And then we spoke about system architects here. At a Kanban level, we also have an enterprise architect. So it is like at a portfolio level also, we can have an enterprise architect ethics. So if there are some architectural initiatives which has to be implemented across the organization, they has to be driven by this individual or this group. So they sit at a top level. So so you may also have a governance matrices. ART
somewhere.
ART matrices. So these are program level matrices, and at this program portfolio management is another group which ensures the complete execution of this cycle. It is coming somewhere next. So this is the program portfolio management group, which talks about that the portfolio is first, they are focusing on strategy and investment and funding. So they look at lean, they look at the demand, they look at what all strategic themes are available and what we can and prioritize. Then they look at program management. In a program management, we have a decentralized rolling wave planning. We talk about agile estimation. So this direction. So portfolio does not limit themselves here, but they do get reports. They do get involved into management, not in execution. So they do get information from here, and this information feed to a governance matrices, agile release train matrices, or a matrices which is coming at a portfolio level. And these matrices helps them to see how these strategies and investments are getting implemented. So it is like closed loop system for a portfolio.
This is like a traditional PMO.
It is. It is a portfolio management group. And portfolio management group, which is based on agile and lean principles, mm-hmm. where we have defined frameworks also. Nothing, concept-wise, the portfolio remains same. Here we are just putting alignment. That's it. So managing knowledge workers, so focuses on leadership. So next focus is that we should be focusing on servant leadership. We should focus on taking the system view. Now who we? The leadership, the foundation. The leaders who are working in safe environment, they should take system view. System view is big picture.
Holistic
view. And a lot of times we talk about that in agile, many times when we work in a small teams, we work on gut feeling. So it says that when things becomes complex, gut feeling doesn't work. You need to take a system view, you need to have proper defined parameters which helps you to see where you go. Take Agile Manifesto, implement product development flow, and focus on exploiting, grooming the potential of knowledge workers. So something focuses on, so the foundation of lean is leadership and foundation of safe is you. So who become trained consultant? So, see, I have not made these slides, okay? So you means you become a safe agile leader by taking a proper things. You can browse the framework, read the books. There are books which are written by Dean. You can build your expertise with the training and certification. Launch your release train. Join the communities like these. LinkedIn also has a community on Lean that is managed by Dean also. You may end up Dean get answering your question. So there is a good community, and this is a certification roadmap. So this is the certification which we were talking in the morning, and this one is the one I would be giving November end. So November last week we are organizing training of Nation Safe, which has all these content. So what you end up knowing in that, the role of each pixel and how they integrate with each other. So in today's session, I good idea. You can get into the details. You can study it on your own also. It's available. But in those training, in that particular 2 days, we'll be focusing on the complete flow, some exercises which will give imbibe you to this particular framework. And then there is a professional level trainings, which is like Safe, Scrum XP, Release Planning, so all
around. So this Safe Consultant.
SPC.
SPC. So one is coaching and training. But as the name is sounding, now if an organization wants to go for SAFE.
So they usually have SAFE.
So you, they would call you and you would have to start thinking right from the, you know, and work with them.
This framework. So we need to implement a complete framework and our work will start when we launch the release train. So the main milestone, and they have a good guidance. They're at a scale
that's what I'm saying. So now if I am assisting any organization to adopt SAFE, I don't have any experience of, I have just done the training, right? So I would need, this is my first project of SAFE.
They have a good support system. They have a good support system. Even they have a template for many things. They have a template for how to conduct a release meeting. What should be agenda for the release meeting? What should be an artifact? Checklists, detailed checklists. But all these are closed ones. You can't get it till the time you are SPC.
That's right. So I can, I have all these things available. I can just follow them for my first.
Yes. And then you have access to a closed community on LinkedIn, which is only for SPC. So whenever you get stuck, you can go there and people do respond. Even Dean end up responding. So if you have any questions.
That is something which should be a topmost.
Yes. And it's not a big community. It's not like there are so many SPC or it's handful. And the problems are also handful, implementations are also handful. So it's manageable. And people like us also get involved, ki chalo kuch hai to dekh lete hain, idhar udhar se seekhte rehte hain. There are few companies who are implementing it, so we end up learning from each other.